Hello everyone, welcome to my paper presentation and eigenvalue based cooperative spectrum sensing for multi-user MIMO cognitive area network under correlated feeding scenario. Myself Abhishek, Dr. Abhishek Kumar, assistant professor BIT Hyderabad. This paper is co-authored by Dr. Srimanti Shah, Rajeshi Bhattacharya and Naveen Gupta. These are my paper presentation outline, which are introduction to cognitive radio, followed by spectrum sensing, cooperative spectrum sensing, brief literature review about the multi-user MIMO cooperative spectrum sensing, major contribution of the paper in energy detection at SU, certain imperfect CSI, eigenvalue based detection at FC under a correlated MIMO radiation feeding channel, followed by simulation study, conclusion and references. Cognitive radio is basically an intelligent radio systems which is came for an efficient spectrum utilization because the fixed spectrum assignment policy leads to an inefficient spectrum utilization by FCC survey. So cognitive radio is the one of the possible solutions for a spectrum utilization or underutilization problems. Cognitive radio works in a cognitive cycles where it first sends the RF world, then analyze the sense data and make their decision to adapt their transmission parameters accordingly for an efficient spectrum utilization. So the observation of the RF world is the primary task for the development of the cognitive radio network in practice. So the first kind of the observation is called as the spectrum sensing. So sense the availability of the spectrum where the cognitive users can transmit their own data. As I said, spectrum sensing is the means of finding the spectrum wide spaces, which is the available spectrum resource, which can be accessed by the secondary users, that is the cognitive users, in an opportunistic manner. But the developing a highly efficient, fast, accurate and reliable spectrum sensing technique is still a most challenging task to implement cognitive radio network in practice. Next. Cooperative spectrum sensing is an attractive approach which combats the multipath fading and shadowing, and it mitigates the receiver uncertainty problem. So it enhances the sensing performance by exploiting the spatial diversity among the cognitive users. By cooperation, more accurate and reliable sensing result is obtained, as it has been represented in the figure 3 in this figure. The basic problem of the sensing of the TU data is loss due to the path loss component and the loss due to the multipath fading and shadowing. And cognitive radio give us the improvement with cooperation gain, which can combat this loss due to the path, multipath and shadowing. Now, let us go with the brief literature review on cooperative spectrum sensing technique. Spectrum sensing techniques, multiple cognitive users, that is secondary users, are trying to sense the primary user data, and the sense data is transmitted to the fusion center for their final and global decision. So they in the final decision making local sensing SUs can send the two types of data to the fusion center, either hard decision, local decision, or the sense data. On the basis of sense data which has been sent from the SU to FC, there are two types of the combining scheme, which are known as hard combining schemes, where SU will send the sense local decision to the fusion center only. That is one bit information. And the another one is the soft combining scheme, where SU will send the total sense data to the fusion center for final global decision making process. In case of the multi-user MIMO based cooperative spectrum sensing, where SU is having the MIMO configuration, which means that SU is going to sense the PU primary user signal by using multiple sense antenna and transmit the sense either sense result or sense data to the fusion center through the multiple transmit antenna, and the fusion center is also going to accept the receive the decision or sense data by using multiple antenna. So here we are combining the diversity gain at both sensing channel scenario and the reporting channel 2. Multi-user cooperative spectrum sensing with MIMO configuration is proposed by P.S. Rossi in 2013, where the multiple antenna at the fusion center has been employed for final or global decision making technique. The multi-user MIMO cooperative spectrum sensing technique is proposed by Eric Patel in 2018, where multiple transmit antenna and the multiple receive antenna at FC is incorporated, but the multiple receive antenna at the SU has been ignored. Towards the proposed eigenvalue based cooperative spectrum sensing for multi-user MIMO cognitive radio network under correlated fitting scenario. Contribution of the paper are as follows. An energy detection is adopted at SUs for local sensing decision, and eigenvalue based detection is adopted at SU for global decision making process. A more realistic scenario is assumed, where the sensing channel is modeled as a Rayleigh fitted channel and the reporting channel is modeled as a correlated MIMO channel with ration fitting, as the cognitive radio users are placed in a close proximity area. Next, the closed form expressions are derived at both SUs for local sensing performance and at FC for global sensing performance. The receiver operating characteristics ROC plot, that is ROC plot, is obtained and plotted to present the performance metrics, the performance of the proposed scheme. The figure shows the considered simulation model, where we are having the multiple SU which is sensing the PU signal through NR antenna and our sensing antenna and transmitting the local decision to the FC using anti transmitting antenna, and FC is receiving all these antenna with the MIMO multiple antennas, which is having a maximum value is an FC. So let us talk about the energy detection at SU. So here the spectrum sensing problem can be considered as the binary hypothesis detection problem, where H naught is the case where the signal is absent, that is YN is equal to WN, and H1 is the case where the signal is present, that is H of XN plus WN. WN is the noise, H is the channel in. So here for the multiple antenna reception, Y, and the, for the kth observation only, we have considered. So YMK, M is for the SUs, MTH SUs. Kth operations, Y is the vector, receive signal vector, which is having the dimension of NR cross 1, because the NR is the number of receive antenna at the SUs. So YMK is equal to HMK plus WN. In case of the imperfect CSI, HM is could be considered as H hat M plus E, where H hat M is the MMSE estimate of HM, so that here sigma. Channel variance maybe is also considered written as sigma square HM is equal to sigma square H hat M plus sigma square error. So in this case of imperfect CSI, YMK could be written as H hat M plus E XK. XK is the PU signal and plus WMK. So we have considered both XK and XN and WN as the zero mean circularly symmetric complex Gaussian channel. Thus, in the case in this scenario, for the log likelihood LRT test, log likelihood ratio test of the received signal could be written as T of YMK, that is delta M, which is the probability of received signal YMK under H1 divided by probability of YMK under H0. So this, as we have assumed this as a Gaussian distributed received signal is having the Gaussian distribution. So this probability density function PDF of a received signal under H1 is written like this: exponential function 1 upon 2 pi sigma square 1 by 2 exponential. And in the case of noise only, this one is the Y by mk square. So by incorporating all NRNT, you know, and reducing the few applying few mathematical steps, this statistic is reduced to t dash y mk, where the summation of n equals to 1 to nr hmk xq ymk in perfect CSI scenario. In imperfect CSI scenario, it will be the h hat mk xk ymk. So the final decision will be taken as it will be 1, that is availability whenever this presence of the signal, whenever the defined test statistic is greater than the lambda m predefined threshold value, and 0 if the test statistic is less than equals to lambda m. So in this this maybe is the case of the right tail probability of Gaussian distribution integration. So in this scenario, probability of detection could be written as q lambda minus lambda minus mu t. Mu is the mean of the test statistic, and sigma square is the variance of the test statistic, which could be written as nr hm square xk in the case of h1, and in the case of h1, and variance could be written as nr hm square mod of hm square x square k sigma e square x square k plus sigma square. Sigma e square is the variance of the noise only. But the problem of this energy detection is that it highly depends upon this threshold, is depends upon the noise power based on the Neyman-Pearson criteria. So inaccurate estimation of noise power leads to the error, gives the error in the case, and it is also not optimal for detecting the correlated signals. Thus, now the proposed eigenvalue based spectrum sensing at FC, where eigenvalue based detection first compares the maximum to average eigenvalue of the sample covariance matrix of a received signal. It does not require the estimate of the noise value too. So in literature 7, the eigenvalue based detection is first presented, where they have used the ratio of maximum eigenvalue to the minimum eigenvalue of the covariance matrix, received signal covariance matrix, and compare this ratio to a predefined threshold to detect the absence and presence of the PU signals. But in practical scenario, sometimes the minimum eigenvalue leads to a very low value, which generates the ill-conditioned matrix for the further calculations, leads to increase in the probability of misdetections too. So that's why we have replaced this minimum eigenvalue with the average eigenvalue based detection technique. To calculate the eigenvalue covariance matrix, we use the L consecutive subsamples, where L is the smoothing factor. So with the L smoothing factor, the received signal yn, xn, and wn is given as this, and further the yn could be written as h of xn, where h is the channel matrix, which is having the dimension of L cross n plus L matrix, and which is given by this. The further the covariance matrix of the received signal could be written as expected value of yn and y hermitian n, and which could be seen like that it is the 1 by n summation of n equals to 1 to L minus 1 plus n. And in this channel formulation, the same covariance matrix could be written as H Rx H to H hermitian plus sigma w square plus IL, which is the variance matrix of the noise. So here we can see in the covariance matrix scenario, if there is no transmission of the PU signal, then Rx is going to be a zero. In that scenario, only the diagonal matrix we will have, and off diagonal elements of the received signal vector is going to be a zero. Here we are going to consider the correlated reporting channel model, where H is going to be replaced with the HR. HR is the correlated reporting channel matrix, which is given by as follows. And here Rx, RTx is the transmit antenna covariance matrix, RRx is the receive antenna covariance matrix, SU is the uncorrelated channel matrix, which is defined with the independent identically distributed complex fading channel coefficients. Rij is the correlation between ith and jth antenna vector, where rho naught signifies the correlation between two correlated antenna, and lambda is the wavelength of the carrier signal. The eigenvalue based test statistic is given by Ty, that is lambda max by lambda average, which has been compared with the threshold delta, where the lambda max and lambda average is obtained by the following expression, where k is given by n minus 1 and p is m into l, and m is the total number of receiving antenna in the case of MIMO CR, n is the total number of receiving samples. Following the analytical performance matrix of eigenvalue based detection at FC, the first equation is the probability of false alarm, and the last equation is represented the probability of detection at FC. Performance study at SU is obtained through the MATLAB simulation, where we have considered the NR value from the range from 2 to 6, and T is equal to 2, and NFC is equal to 2 to 4 at FC, and rho naught is equal to 0.15, and 10,000 Monte Carlo simulation has been performed. So we can see here, even by employing NR is equal to 6 at even at the 0 dB, SNR is equal to 0 dB, we are having almost 1 probability of detection, but probability of detection is reaching to 1. But in the case of minus 5 dB SNR, the probability of detection is around 0.78, with the false alarm probability is having 0.2 value. In the ROC plot at FC, where we can conclude that with the antenna configuration of 2x4, we can have the optimum performance even at very low probability of false alarm. So finally, this work is concluded, as in this work, the multi-user MIMO cooperative spectrum sensing for cognitive radio network is presented, where each SU is modeled as MIMO systems. First, the local decision performance is obtained at each SU by employing energy detection over daily fading scenario, radio fading sensing scenario. Further, we obtained the global decision performance at FC by employing eigenvalue based detection over MIMO correlated reporting channel with ration fading. Finally, the performance evaluation at FC shows that the detection performance is almost equals to 1 under correlated MIMO reporting channel model at FC, with SNR is equal to 0 dB and T is equal to 2 and NRF is equal to 4. These are the any queries or suggestions, kindly write us at abhishek.ec14@nitp.ac.in. We will be very happy to acknowledge your queries and suggestions. Thank you.